In this video, I will share with you three secrets that will make it look like you play a whole lot better than you actually do on the violin. So, how do you notice that somebody is a beginner violinist versus somebody is playing for a while already? Interestingly enough, it is sometimes different than you would think, and sometimes some things are more important than they seem and other things are less important than they seem. So let's have a look at first your posture. One very common thing that beginner violinists do is to look a little bit confused at their fingerboard on the moment that they play. So they will look confused, and also often their violin is hanging down a little bit and their bow is kind of crooked and they look very tense. The first thing that you can do to look better on the violin and to make a better impression on your violin teacher is to really relax as much as you can and stand up very straight, a tall posture, but also a proud posture. If you look proud on what you are playing, even though it doesn't sound perfect yet, but if you look proud and relaxed as possible, it directly looks a whole lot better and you don't even need to change anything about your technique. The second thing that will directly make a really big difference in your playing is that you play a little bit softer with your bow, but especially that you play every note until the end. So a very common beginner sound is this. What I'm doing currently is not only playing every note quite loud and intense, but also I am really stopping the bow after each note. What I want you to do instead is to play every note until the end, even if you would still have not a very good bowing, so again, I use the same bowing. It's not a beautiful bowing, but because I am playing every note until the end and not leaving any space. Do you hear it? Go on, go on. You can practice that on an open string. So not. Don't stop the bow after a note. Play on. And you stop the note by going in another direction. So you play and go. Never stop the bow arm. Always move with the bow arm. Of course, there's exceptions. Sometimes you want it. You want some kind of sound that is like very specific and stopping the notes in between. But normally we don't want that. And normally you sound like a beginner if you do. So make sure to all the time continue bowing. You don't need to have the perfect bowing. You don't need to have every single note in the right place. But just by continuing you're bowing all the time, you already sound a whole lot more professional. Something why beginners don't do this, because they feel so insecure. So they are like, oh, what is the second note? I'm not sure. You kind of feel it in stopping the bow that you are insecure. And sometimes you're afraid that you place your finger in the incorrect place. So you stop and then you're like, oh, I hope I will place it correctly. So one part of this is also just accepting that maybe it won't sound perfect, but still I'm going to play full out every single note and play every single note until the end without stopping the bow at any time. So now let's go to the third secret. What else will help you to look better than you actually are on the violin? And actually you're becoming a better player by already applying these tips. One other thing you can do to look like a better violinist than you actually are is to choose a piece that is suiting for you. So one very, very common thing that I see among especially those that are learning the violin online is to choose really hard pieces. And no matter how much you practice, of course at some point you learn the pieces, but even if you're practicing for 3 months and you choose to play a concerto, it is quite logical that it doesn't sound very good. And actually, it makes you sound worse if you're playing a concerto not very good than if you would be playing an easier part really good. So what I suggest instead is to find a piece that is really suitable for your level. So for instance, don't start with Four Seasons on the moment you get started. I have so many students that come to the first lesson and they are like, Julia, I want to learn how to play Four Seasons from Vivaldi. And I'm like, yeah, that's great. And I really adore it if people really go for a goal and for their big dreams. But at the same time, you need to take small steps in order to arrive at your destination. And one of the small steps you can take is to play easier pieces first. It will make you so much more confident as you really truly master the piece, and then you can move on to another piece that you can truly master, and that gives you such a better feeling than all the time playing pieces that are way too difficult, that are above your level, and each time you will end up frustrated because you feel like you have learned nothing, even though you did learn a lot, but it was just not enough to master that specific piece yet. So what kind of pieces could you play that will sound a little bit easy, but also a little bit impressive? One of the pieces that is quite easy, but will also impress, especially your grandmother, is Ode to Joy from Beethoven. It is a classical piece, but still very easy to learn, and you can find a tutorial on my channel for that. If you would prefer to play some kind of pop song or film music song, I recommend, if you are a little bit higher level, you can learn He's a Pirate, but the easy version that you can find on my channel. I really assure you that it does impress quite a lot of people. I had quite some students that have learned this piece at maybe a few months of playing the violin, 4 or 5 months of playing, and people were really impressed that they could already play it. They were even impressed themselves. So make sure to have a look also at the easy tutorial of He's a Pirate. I hope these tips helped you to really look like a better violinist and also hopefully to become a better violinist in the process. I think if we only believe we are better players, we are automatically already looking like a better player because we present ourselves differently, but also for ourselves it really helps to get more confidence if we play pieces on our level and if we are standing up straight and tall, and if we keep bowing and try to create a tone at all times, we will feel more confident ourselves and we will become better players. So I hope these tips helped you. If you would like to support this channel, make sure to give me a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. I really look forward to see you next week, hopefully, for my next violin tutorial. Until then, goodbye, good luck practicing.